The messenger, peace be upon him, was sent to us in order to teach us how to worship Allah. That was the reason why he was sent. He was sent to teach us how the Almighty wants to be worshipped. So if anyone comes up with an act of worship that was not taught by the messenger, peace be upon him, he has directly insulted the messenger and he has also directly insulted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reason is, what was the point of sending a messenger to teach us how to worship Allah when we think we know better than him? May Allah protect us.
Some people say, well, okay, leave that aside. Just the idea of celebrating his birthday, what are we doing in the celebration? We're only remembering Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're asking Allah to bless him. You know, these are all good things. We remember his seerah, his life, and all this. These are all good things. You say this is not good in Islam? Yes, these things are good things. But to combine them on that day, every year, you have now created something new in the religion. This is bid'ah.
Now going to Mawlid al-Nabi, the Prophet ﷺ's birthday, if you want to analyze this, to know if it's a sunnah or an innovation, first of all, people celebrate it on the 12th day of Rabi al-Awwal. And the authentic opinion of scholars that the Prophet was born on the 9th of the third month of the Islamic calendar. The consensus of all scholars that he died on the 12th of Rabi al-Awwal, or the third month of the Islamic calendar, which means when you claim to be celebrating the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're actually celebrating his death. So if you come to the Mawlid, the celebration of the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam celebrate his own Mawlid? The answer would be no. The only indication to his birthday was that he used to fast on Mondays. He never celebrated anything to do with the third month of the year, on the 12th, that is. And they asked him, why do you fast Mondays? So he told them that this is the day that I was born in, and this is the day that I was revealed in. Allah revealed the Quran on that day. So if you wish to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fast every Monday. The Prophet himself did not celebrate his birthday, nor did his companions, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali. May Allah be pleased with them all. And no one doubted that they loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than we did. The Prophet himself did not celebrate the birthday of his grandfather Abraham, or Jesus, or Moses, or any of the prophets of Allah, which indicates that it is a clear innovation. So whoever celebrates the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ, he either knows more than the Prophet, and this is blasphemous, because no one knows more than the Prophet ﷺ, or he is claiming that the Prophet knew that it is good to celebrate, but he did not inform his ummah. And again, he is accusing the Prophet ﷺ of betraying the message and not delivering all, and this is again an act of blasphemy. In short, celebrating the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ is an innovation, something that was fabricated not in the first 100 years or the second or the third. It was fabricated on the fourth century of Islam. So no one of the scholars ever approved of it or agreed to it.
So if somebody turns around and says this is not love of the Prophet, is this showing any, say, unjust love towards the Prophet ﷺ?
Well, this is a form of an escape, because people who celebrate the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ claim that there is a fabricated hadith, it's not authentic. They say that this is a hadith. Whoever celebrates the birthday, my birthday, then Allah will forgive his sins. So it's like the Christians. They do whatever they do, and then they celebrate on Christmas and do wrong things on Christmas and claim that by their belief in Jesus Christ, this erases all their sins. In Islam, likewise, those innovators claim that no matter what you do, if you come on the day of the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ, you know, cry a little bit, say some poetry, and pretend that you are celebrating the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ, this shows your great love, and hence this will make all your sins forgiven. And this is completely wrong. If you love the Prophet ﷺ, you follow him in every single detail. Otherwise, you are claiming something and your actions are falsifying.
So they say, well, you know, this is something good. They may even bring a verse from the Quran. They would say, Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. They bring this verse out. And you say, well, what does it say celebrate the Prophet's birthday there? It's there. This is what it means. It's their interpretation. Right? Their interpretation. The point is that the companions of the Prophet ﷺ didn't understand that verse that way. And that's why they never celebrated his birthday. And he himself didn't understand that verse that way, and he didn't celebrate his birthday. And the early generations didn't celebrate his birthday. It wasn't until some 400 years after the time of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ that his birthday began to be celebrated in Egypt, in the Fatimid Shiite rule. In the Fatimid Shiite dynasty in Egypt, the celebration of the Prophet ﷺ's birthday began.
Brothers and sisters, if you take a look at Surah Al-Kahf, towards the end Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the biggest losers. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, should I inform you of the one who is the greatest of losers, or those who are the greatest of losers of their deeds? People who have spoiled their deeds completely. They are those whose struggle was always astray. They neither followed the path of the messenger. They did deeds, acts of worship, which were not taught, not done by the messenger. May peace be upon him. And they thought that they were doing good. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Beloved brothers and sisters, never ever think that there is a single act of worship that the messenger forgot to teach us. Never ever think that there is any act of worship that you may engage in that would be better than what the messenger has come with. And never ever think that the messenger has not done the deeds which were enough for us to follow. So now we need to come up with a new deed and a new act of worship that would result in the spoiling of your deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us. Brothers and sisters, Islam is very easy. It is us sometimes who add the salt and pepper to our religion in order to try and decorate it with innovation, not realizing innovation can never decorate your cake, but instead it will make it unpalatable, that which can never be consumed. May the Almighty protect us from innovation of every sort.